Hi guys, I am in an absolute state of grumpiness and discomfort at the moment because we are in between moving and it's been like exhausting, but I won't bore you with that. I really wanted to do this video. I don't have the best setup for it. It's impossible to create a good setup at the moment, but I wanted to do it anyway because I've really been enjoying this Louis Vuitton stationery, and I wanted to talk about whether it would be, you know, if I think it would be worth it, if I would recommend it, and why and why not. I'll briefly touch on the notebook covers, maybe at the end, but I'd prefer to do a separate video on them, I think. But what I really wanted to talk about are these notebooks, because I wasn't sure about them for a while, and recently I've been using them a lot and I love them. So this is the one I'm currently using. It's a Clemence notebook. So they're called the Clemence notebook, and they come out with various different limited edition designs regularly. This was, I think, the most recent Christmas collection, and it's like a travel series. So this one is Paris, it's a scene from Paris, but you get New York, you get London, for different notebooks. And this one, I can't remember what it's called, but it's, you know, it's a beautiful monogram canvas cover. They both have that monogram canvas cover with just an interesting design on it. And I like this one because it was not too in your face. It wasn't too funky. It wasn't too out there, but it was really pretty with the colors. And I think it looks even nicer in real life if you've got a chance to check them out in the actual store. So I have counted these to have 222 lined pages. So halve that number for actual papers. You know, that'd be around 111 actual papers and 222 lined pages. But I counted that, so it could be off by, you know, a few pages on either side. They've got gold gilded edges, like really nice gilding. And each one comes with a bookmark of a color that is specific to that particular notebook. If you open each one up, the front page will be a particular color or design. So that one's dark blue, this one's red with some of the, you know, the Louis Vuitton symbols on it, and the same goes for the back. This one says Louis Vuitton made in Paris at the back. I'm really sorry about the lighting, guys. It's just impossible to get a good filming situation going on here. Louis Vuitton Paris made in Italy. I think these books are made in Italy. So they're basically what they are. They are bound in that lay flat way, you know what I mean by that type of binding, but because they are they've got these canvas covers, the same will be true if you've got a leather bound cover, like in a Smithson notebook, however you pronounce that. If you have something that's not a paper cover, even with that lay flat binding, it will really kind of struggle to lay flat, and you have to train it. The more you use it, and the more you train it, it does help. And it certainly doesn't open in an uncomfortable way. It will always open fairly flat. So this is mine that I've been using for a while. This is a newer one. Even if I open this one up, this one needs a little, you can see, like, it needs training. Otherwise, it'll just do that. With training, not a huge amount of training, but just a little bit of training, it will do that. So it's not going to be like Hobonichi flat in a sense, but it's not going to be far from that either. You're also not going to be able to fold it over and, you know, fold it in the way that you can fold Hobonichi paper-bound books, because it's just not paper, right? It's not bound in paper. So that's a couple of the drawbacks. Before I go into what I like about it and what's less good about it and my experience with it, the other design feature I wanted to point out is that some of these notebooks will have little designs throughout the pages. So you can see that little Vivienne doll there holding a bag. Here there's Vivienne next to Paris with the car. So it kind of depends on the book. Like, I have one that's got animals on it, and it's got little animals all over the, it won't be every page, but it'll almost be every other, like it'll be every few pages. So you can see the frequency. So if you don't like that in your notebooks, that's something to note, that some of them have this, but not all of them. So this one doesn't, I believe, have any of that. Yeah, this is just black. And the refills, I'll tell you why I'm calling them refills in a second, also don't have any of that stuff going on in them. They're just blank. So just watch out for that. If you, this one is, I think it's about maybe 40 bucks less, that's Australian dollars, so I don't know in American or other countries, but it's just slightly less expensive than this one. And I think the ones that are just slightly more expensive are actually more likely to have those graphics throughout. But the only way to be really sure would be to look at the book in store, I would say, you know, because there might not be photos on the website that will show you. So that's kind of the basic design feature. There's no strap anymore. The older ones used to have a strap. These ones tend to not. It doesn't have a pen loop. It's a really simple, it's just a notebook covered with the coated canvas. It doesn't have a clasp. Okay, so having said that, I'm going to take this one away, put this one down here, and I'm just going to talk about my pros and cons and how I am using it. So do I think you should get one? Let's put the cost aside because it's such a personal thing. That's for you to decide what you want to spend on a notebook. So putting that aside, I'd say absolutely. I would say the pros overcome the cons. So one pro, I honestly think it just feels beautiful to use this. Again, that is a bit subjective, but I'd be surprised if you didn't love the feel of the coated canvas. You know, and you didn't like the paper. The paper is, it's a high quality paper. It's thin. Okay, so if you like thick paper, this wouldn't be something you would enjoy. If you like thin, high quality paper, you would love this. I love the way thin paper feels when you've written on it and you're turning the pages. I just think it's gorgeous. I'm just looking through mine that I've been using, and with my Sarasa pens, there tends to not be much bleed through. There can be a tiny bit of bleed through here and there, nothing too significant, but there would be ghosting and shadowing and stuff. So if you like that in your notebooks because it gives it a real lived-in, used feel, then you will really like this paper. It feels really soft and smooth, and I enjoy it. So it just feels good. It is the size of this is slightly bigger than B6, if I use the refill, it is, if you put a Stalogy on top of this, you will notice that the Stalogy is noticeably smaller than this refill. So the refill, these books are in between A5 and B6. Maybe closer to B6 than they are to A5. So here's an A5. I really wish I had my B6 next to me. Typical that I don't have it next to me. I actually think it's a good in-between size. It's not, you can't even say it's definitely closer to B6 than A5. I feel like it's in some ways just right in the middle of those two sizes. But that makes it a really kind of nice, compact, but roomy size to be writing in and using. So I love that. I think it feels beautiful. It looks stunning. And there's loads of different designs. So you can choose the one that visually appeals to you. I don't always like every design they come out with, and some of the designs I really love. So I tend to buy, if I see a design I love, I do tend to buy it even if I haven't finished the previous book, because it might take a while before another design comes out that I really like. But you can get one to your taste. I think the monogram cover in general looks gorgeous, and I actually much prefer it to leather covers. Louis Vuitton do have some of these in leather covers, and Smithson do a lot of leather bound books, and I just tend to prefer the coated canvas. I don't know why. I definitely think the coated canvas ages better than leather coated notebooks do, because the kind of leather you use to coat a notebook is not that great quality leather, and so over time it definitely wears. And I've seen like Smithson books that have worn over time and they are not looking great, whereas I just think monogram is just consistently indestructible, so it will always retain this beautiful, like, I've taken this around with me, I've had it for a while now, it still looks new, you know, it looks beautiful, so it will retain that look. If you like your books to kind of get really old and used and lived in, then this wouldn't really be the right look for you. But if you actually like them to retain their shape, retain their structure, and just look new all the time, then this is perfect for you. And I have realized that I've wanted to be the first kind of person where I enjoy it, aging and getting all tatty, but in reality I actually just really like the new look. I gravitate to the new look, which is why I probably often yearn to start a new book, and so I prefer this look. Okay, so it feels beautiful, it looks stunning, the paper is really enjoyable. Now, wide lines, I've often heard people talk about Japanese notebooks and just how small the line spacing is, because the handwriting tends to be smaller. And these are really wide, you know, your typical old-fashioned wide lines. I have small handwriting myself, but my handwriting is very malleable. I can have like four different types of handwriting. And so I can make my handwriting fit whatever book I'm using. And I noticed that with wide lines, it does feel more comfortable even for me, because it's just easier. I don't have to think about it as much. I can write faster. I can write messier while still being legible, and I'm really enjoying writing in that. So I can't show you what's on the other side, but you know, this is an example of how I've molded my writing to fit this, and I just really enjoy it. Okay, so wide lines, and they're dark, so you're not going to have any trouble seeing the lines. Now, aesthetically, is that as good? I would tell you that the more you use this notebook, the less the darkness of the lines, that's going to be aesthetically a problem. Initially, I was like, aesthetically, I don't like seeing these dark lines. The more I used it, the more I liked it. And I think that's just true of a lot of features of notebooks. The more you use it, the more you do like it. Okay, so bookmark, really handy. Like so when I'm talking about this, I'm really comparing it against a whole range of other notebooks. Your Stalogies, your Tomo River notebooks, you know, your Archer and Olives, you know, whatever it is, those are all your other options. Some of those, so that an Archer and Olive will come with bookmarks, but a Stalogy and the Japanese ones often sometimes do and sometimes don't, depends on if it's a diary or if it's just a notebook. Now, this, despite just being a notebook, this comes with a lovely ribbon bookmark. It's nothing fancy, but I like that it's a different color for each book, and that the coloring just matches, and there's pop, you know, like this dark pop on the inside, and I just really like it, and it's handy to have a bookmark, so I like that. They're collectible because they're all limited editions in a sense. Like, I feel like these are super limited editions because they're like a part of a collection, but in a way they all are, because they all come and go. There'll be a point, this is currently available, it's been available for most of the year, but there'll be a time when it's no longer available and you just can't get it anymore. So it's kind of nice to have like a limited edition book, because it's quite unique and it's yours, and it's just nice, right? Like, Stalogy is always a Stalogy. They do have limited edition colors with Stalogies for certain sizes, and those are nice too. So I really enjoy like the fact that it comes and it goes, in particular designs. Another pro is I feel a lot more motivated to finish this notebook than I have felt to finish any notebook, but not in that way where you want to rush through it and you just want to put anything in it just to say you finished it, or just to be finished. It's you genuinely just want to stick with the notebook and use it like you've been using it until it's done. You don't want to just stick stuff in it because it's an expensive notebook. It's a beautiful notebook. You love it. So that's not how you want to treat the notebook, just to be done. You don't feel like you just want to be done. You just feel like you want to use it all the time. And you would just never abandon it because it's just, it's expensive, it's valuable. I'm certainly not at the income or disposable income level where I could treat this like, you know, like, unfortunately I treat my Stylogies, which are not cheap notebooks either, but, you know, cheaper. And so I find myself treating them in a way I kind of wish I didn't, but I just wouldn't do that with this one because, you know, I don't know why, but I would never think of abandoning it. I would just keep going with it until I finished. Which is great, right? Because we all want to finish our notebooks. I think deep down inside, that's what we want. And lots of us struggle with it. And so I don't think you're going to have the struggle if you get this notebook and you start using it. Starting to use it is another issue, and I'll come back to that. And then, yeah, I've already talked about how indestructible the canvas is. So, you know, it will retain its shape and quality. And just in on that, so those are my pros. I just want to say I love the notebook. I haven't loved the notebook for a long time, because I haven't used it and I have felt like I wouldn't love it. And I wanted it as part of my collection, but I felt like I wouldn't love using it. And so I never did use it, which was very strange. Then I started using it and I loved it. So now let's just go. So overall, I do highly recommend, as long as you open this book and you start writing in it. A lot of people use these books as journals. I do not. I'm not a journaler. I don't enjoy journaling. I do have a 5-year journal where I write a very small amount. That is enough for me. In general, I don't enjoy journaling. I never read back on journals, even though I try to keep them. They're not for me, but I love taking notes. And to me, the notes I take tell me more about my life and what was going on with me, often than a journal sometimes does. Or, you know, it tells me as much, or it tells me things in a different way. And I really enjoy that. So I do like looking back on previous notes I've taken. I do like flipping through them, and I love, and everyone needs to take notes in life, you know, here and there, to be more productive and organized. So that's how I've been using mine. But let me go to the cons, okay? So the only options are for lined notebooks. You don't get grid, you don't get blank, you don't get dot grid. That is a con, because it does limit what you can do in here, you know? There are certain things you can do with grid and dot grid notebooks that are much harder to do if you've only got lines and don't look as good with lines. So that's a shame. The second, look, it's cost, but cost is subjective. So I would never recommend getting a notebook that was priced at such a price that you regretted getting it. That's all I would say about that. Third, you feel reluctant to use it because of the price. You may feel that way. So even if you feel like you can afford it, you still feel hesitant to start using it, because it's still, while it may be affordable for you, it may still be at a price range where, shit, crap, that is an expensive notebook. Okay, so, and it's also really pretty, and I think very pretty notebooks can be difficult to get started writing in, so you want to save it for something special. I would advise against that if possible. I think saving it for something special is a recipe for never using your notebook, and therefore not getting enjoyment out of it, and then just getting stressed that they're there and you're not using them instead. The best thing I ever did was open it and just start scribbling away my notes, my irrelevant notes. And it's just caused me a lot of joy in experiencing these notebooks. So if you just can get over that initial reluctance, that'll be fantastic, but do be prepared to feel that reluctance, which is not great. I've talked about the binding and how it's lay flat binding, but it's not going to lay flat because of the canvas cover unless you train it a bit. And even then it won't lay as flat as if this was paper binding. So even this refill lays flat better than the canvas does. Okay, even immediately you can tell that's going to lay flat better. But even this one doesn't lay flat perfectly. I need to think about why, because technically I think this is paper, like it's cardstock. Maybe it's too thick. I'm not sure why, because it is the lay flat binding that's been used, I believe. It may be just that I haven't trained it enough. I'm not sure. But you know, that's something to look at. However, it is trainable. I don't really think it's an issue. Even if you enjoy lay flat blinding, as long as you don't need it to be like absolutely completely flat all the time. This one is untrained. This one is a bit more trained. I think you'll be fine. And do not hesitate to train it because it's monogram. Monogram, indestructible. Do not worry about it. You know, do not worry about it. So the lay flat, yeah, that's one point. And then the final point I had in there, look, it can be difficult to use covers with these. So these will fit in the Paul MM notebook covers, which are also, you know, they release regularly in different designs. This is you know, a newer design that they've released that matches with one of my handbags, and I absolutely love it. It does fit in there. These are designed for these refills. They just slide in easier because it's cardstock rather than canvas, but these will fit. Just they don't slide in as easily. But if you put these in there, it just looks a bit funny. It doesn't look like it's meant to be in there. And it's not meant to be in there. These are meant to be standalone notebooks that you don't use with covers. Like, they're designed to not be used with covers. That's why they've got their own cover. They've got their monogram cover on them. And it's very beautiful. And you don't want to hide it under a cover. So then in the end, you don't have a cover. However, please don't worry about not having a cover. I really think the canvas holds up and you don't have to overly worry about having to baby it. The only thing is, without a clasp, the pages could get dented in your bag, but it's easy to get like a band to put around it if you want to. I don't tend to. I've not had any problems so far. It just takes a little degree of care. So those are the pros and cons. In terms of the refills are like a third or a quarter the cost of, yeah, closer to a quarter, I'd say, between a third and a quarter the cost of the monogram ones. And the only difference, they're not going to have the special edition graphics, but then they don't all have the graphics anyway. I would say the only difference is that they don't have the monogram. They don't have this pop of color or whatever, you know? They have this color in them. They do have a bookmark. I'll show you here. It's like a beigey bookmark. It's beautiful. And that's kind of their indifference. The cover is like the Louis Vuitton bag or the boxes. It's like this. It's made of this, but a thicker cardstock version of that. Now, should you just get this and use this by itself, as opposed to, say, getting this and using it by yourself? Absolutely. Why not? You know, I would. If I felt like this one, which is like about a quarter of the cost of this one, was comfortably affordable and I liked it, and I would like it, I do like it, then I would absolutely get it and use it by myself. I think if you use this by itself, this would ultimately get a bit dented up and dingy, just like any like paper covered notebook would. But if you didn't mind that, and I probably wouldn't mind it that much, even though I'd prefer it to look pristine, it wouldn't stop me, then I would, because it also has the gold gilt edge. It's beautiful, it's stunning, I love the feel of it, it's nice, it's a great size, so I would. It's maybe not meant to be used that way. It's meant to be a refill for the Paul cover, but who cares, right? If it works for you, it works for you. I don't think it would look odd. I think it would look like a beautiful, like, luxury notebook. If, you know, money's not an option, I would definitely choose. It's not, if money's not an issue, as between these two, I would definitely choose this one. This does open and they feel a little bit easier. You can feel it. You can just feel that there's less resistance when you do that, versus the canvas, as I would expect. So that might be something you take into account as well. So I have just loved using these. I will probably just stick with these from now on. When I look at my Stylogy now, I realize it's just not for me. I do just like that pristine, like super nice look all the time versus that lived in, beaten up look. I appreciate that look in other people's notebooks. I appreciate it in some of mine, but in general, I just want it to look like this. So maybe what that really means is I will just use a variety of notebooks throughout my life for different things, and this will always be one of them. I hope they always make these. I think they're great. So that's going to be the end of this, and I would like to come back and do a video on some covers I've been using. This I've been using less. I need to really think about how to use this. This is the Paul MM sized notebook. This I've been using heaps. I've got another version of this called the August notebook cover. It is an A5. It is a proper A5 notebook cover. You don't have to trim your A5 book to fit in here. You really can't comfortably put both sides in. It's just not designed that way because it's stiffer. It's not that it can't fit. At least if it's a half size, like the AVEC, it will certainly fit, but it just won't open nicely. It's designed for you to put like one book in, and you can put the other, you can put another book in the other side. But I'll come and talk about, I believe it's designed that way. But I'll come and talk about that later. I think these seem to be kind of new. Like they had it a while ago and they had it in a they had like a PM version, and I feel like they had a GM, and it was called the GM, the A5 size, and then it just went away, and then it came back, and the first iteration I saw it come back in is my August, which is like a black monogram cover with some graffiti type painting kind of on it. I've done a video on it before, so if you look through my past videos, you'll see it. And I got it, and it looks so much better in real life than it did on the photos. It's still my favorite one. And this one is more recent. It's called Monogram Comics. And I will always look out for these because I think they're perfect. I use a Hobonichi AVEC in it. It's just changed. The thing that has changed my planning life is committing to the fact that I don't like the full year cousin. It's too heavy. It's just too heavy. And as much as I love the idea of having the whole year in one book, once I put a cover on it, it's all just too heavy and it feels too tough on my wrists. And then you add things like extra notebooks and it's all too much. The AVEC is just perfect. So it took me a while to accept that. Now I've accepted it. It's great. Because it's canvas and not leather. Sorry, because it's leather on the inside, but canvas on, this is leather, but canvas on the outside, it's just so light. It feels so light and comfortable in the hands, even though it's A5, and I just love it. But I will do a separate video on that later. Okay, thanks guys. I hope that was helpful. But feel free to ask me any questions. I may not see them just because busy with the move, and also just not on YouTube much, and don't really have social media anymore, so I might not see it, but if I do see it, I'll definitely try to answer where I can. Okay, thank you, bye.